Days after TDP chief and the main opposition leader, Chandrababu Naidu, wrote to the Prime Minister saying that there seems to be some kind of spying and phone tapping, not only on his phone, but he said that also journalists, activists and others were involved in this. There seems to be a bit of a controversy around this. After Chandrababu Naidu wrote this letter, the DGP, Gautam Sawang, he also responded and he said that if you show me evidence, I will see to it that this is solved. The TDP chief was not satisfied. He said, why should I show you evidence? It is your duty to prove what is wrong with the state, particularly the Jagan Mohan Reddy government, which seems to be spying on us. They are tapping our phones. They are listening into conversations, which is actually an offense, as you very well know. And now what has happened is that it is not just an opposition leader like Chandrababu Naidu who is accusing that the Jagan Mohan Reddy government is listening into conversations, but one MP from his own party, which is Raghuram Krishna Raju, who has also said that he suspects that his phones are also being tapped. He says he's got two mobile phones and he says, I can hear disturbances and other things. To speak more about the matter, we are now joined by Deepak Reddy, an MLC from TDP. So what exactly is going on, you know, Mr. Deepak, what exactly is going on? You know, there seems to be this kind of slugfest, spying, listening into conversations. I mean, this is a very sad state of affairs.
Extremely. We just celebrated our 74th Independence Day. But I have to be honest, we don't feel we are independent in Andhra. Andhra is nothing but Jungle Raj. Ever since Jagan Mohan Reddy's government has come to power in the last 15 months, all they're doing is political terrorism, vendetta, atrocities and cases. Out of the four pillars of democracy, three pillars are already knocked down. And the only remaining pillar left in Andhra is the judiciary. So what has happened is they are brutally attacking the judiciary for the last couple of months. On the media, the leaders of
Mr. Reddy, let me just intervene here because we want to know, of course, you know, all the facts will come to the fore once the investigation is over. But one needs to understand, we also saw, you know, the DGP Gautam Sawang's letter, which was doing the rounds, right? Now, the thing is, he says, you give us evidence, you know. And of course, Chandrababu Naidu objected to it and he said that, you know, this is very bizarre because one doesn't expect the police chief to actually respond to this. But let's go back to the genesis of the problem. Why do you feel that not just politicians, but even activists, journalists and lawyers' phones are being tapped?
Let me give you an example. About a few months ago, we had a three capital bill put in the legislature. And right. we as MLCs, yes, we were discussing certain crucial issues on that. And one of the YCP leader has actually come up to me and discussed those critical points, what we spoke between ourselves. And we got a doubt, yes, our phones are being tapped. And in fact, one of the officer from the intelligence department, way back about 4 months ago, has come and told me that I can't come on record, but the level of tapping what is going on in Andhra Pradesh, I think, nowhere in India such thing is going on. So you people have to be very careful when you are talking on the phones. And the similar experience has been faced by their own MP, Raghuram Krishna Raju. This is what is happening. What is happening in Andhra Pradesh is tapping, tracking and hacking. This is a fact which they can't avoid. And the DGP writing a letter to our national president is the biggest joke of the 15-month period of Jagan Mohan Reddy's government. Because we have given n number of complaints in n number of cases, over more than 1,000, and no action has been taken. But in this case, the DGP is voluntarily written a letter.
I hear you. Mr. Reddy, I do hear you. I also have Mr. Mehboob Sheikh on the phone line. Let's listen to his side of the story. What is going on, Mr. Mehboob Sheikh? I mean, this is breach of privacy. It is an offense, for God's sake.
Madam, one thing. This is all false allegations. Automatically, this Chandrababu Naidu, if he is having evidences, it is his duty to produce to the police commissioner or DGP or someone, which is not giving and is writing directly a letter to the BJP government. Let him write. That is not a problem or anything. He has to prove. any evidences. Without evidences, I can also say Chandra Babu Naidu daily is having a conversation with some other people.
What do you expect now, Mr. Reddy? Because there's been a letter from the DGP also, but what steps now? How does one really protect oneself against this breach of privacy? What steps are you next going to take?
We have no other option other than to tap the doors of the Honorable Prime Minister of India. We have to be part of India. We have to be part of the Indian democracy.
Right.
So I think it is time the Prime Minister steps
in. Absolutely.
And ask for an investigation on this.
I hope Prime Minister Modi steps in. But meanwhile, Mr. Mehboob Sheikh, if you are with us, now I want you to tell me, Mr. Sheikh, you know, that what do you have to say about what, you know, Raju Garu said just now, and you heard my telephonic conversation with him where he says two things. One, it could be the state intelligence.
Mr. Deepak Reddy, I have not seen, madam, that what he has given conversation, because there is some disturbance.
I'm talking about Raju Garu. Mehboob Sheikh. Mehboob Sheikh. Raju Garu said, he said he does not expect anything better from this government. You know, he's a member of parliament. He belongs to your party and he has no expectations. He says his phone is being tapped. He says the state intelligence could be involved in it. Shocking, isn't it?
Madam, one thing I can say, just giving, he said, he never said Jagan Mohan Reddy or any party people involved. He said intelligence. He would have complained to intelligence commissioner or something like that. If he is having doubt, that who is this thing? He told the investigation
by Sheikh.
Intelligence.
Mr. Sheikh.
He can come give a complaint.
Dr. Sheikh.
Yeah, madam.
Dr. Sheikh, aap puri baat to sun lijiye. You please listen to me completely. Two parts to this. One is, he also says, although he says that Jagan Mohan Reddy may not be personally involved, he says, I do not expect anything from this party. Let me repeat that. I do not expect anything from this party. That shows your party in a very, very bad light, is all I'm saying. The confidence level of such a senior leader is getting lost.
First of all, he should have credibility to ask, being in party, which he already indirectly is having liaison with Chandra Babu Naidu, Raju Garu, and he may be liaison with BJP people. We don't know. He is giving all nonsense comments.
Great.
Since,
in doubt, shakes up. This is what I like about politicians, When in doubt, you say he must be in talks with TDP, he must be in talks with BJP.
Yeah,
you don't want to clean out what is going on within your own party.
See, he is not having, he is our party, but he contested on our party. Recently, you had seen his way of behavior or anything, and he said he is claiming that he is in party, but according to the party cadre, he is not moving. He want to put some allegations and he want to run away from the party, that's all.
You are refusing to look at the actual issue. So let me just thank you both, Dr. Mehboob Sheikh and Deepak Reddy, both of you, for speaking with India Ahead. This is not only about politics. It is, of course. But it is also about breach of privacy. It's an offense. And I don't think that we can just brush it under the carpet, whether in Andhra Pradesh or Telangana or Tamil Nadu, and say it's all about politics, that I'm listening into what you're saying, I will use your statement against each other. I think it is time, like Mr. Deepak Reddy said, that the centre intervenes to solve this problem.